Alright, we've got the mat and the ball. When you're ready, we're gonna start laying down on our back. So, just in a nice neutral position. Try to draw those shoulder blades down. Find a nice neutral spine position, little pocket of air underneath the low back. And we'll start here with our breathing, inhaling through your nose, and exhaling out your mouth. As you inhale, feel your ribcage expand out to the side. As you exhale, pull the ribcage together, belly button to spine, almost drawing the bottom of the ribcage towards the hips. Take a few big breaths here, just pushing away the thoughts from outside. Inhaling through your nose and exhaling out your mouth. Take a couple more big breaths here. Maybe lift the knees, sway side to side. Getting some movement to the spine. We'll pause with the knees back together. You're gonna keep knees together, feet on the mat. We're gonna open into a butterfly and then close the knees, just kind of opening up the hips. So you can do, as you do this, continuing to breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth, just getting a little movement to the hips and the legs here. Do this in a range that feels okay. Two more like this. On this next one, you can hold open. If that doesn't feel comfortable, you can always close the knees back. You're gonna open arms out to a T, palms facing up. You're gonna take the palms together like you're closing a book. Inhale, exhale, open up the arms. Just getting a little bit of stretch to the arms and the fingertips here, either in that butterfly position or with the knees bent. Take a few here, just kind of warming up, getting those arms nice and stretched out, hips are open. Let's do two more. Last one, pause with palms down, or hands down to the ground. We'll just snow angel those arms a little bit, opening up the shoulders here. Fingertips are just hovering right off the ground. Just a little stretch here, start warming up, getting some movement. And then we'll take hands to the hips, palms flip down, bring the knees back together to that neutral spine position. We're gonna grab our ball. So ball is gonna go right around the upper back, and then we'll come to knees bent, feet flat, ball is right around the upper back. If the ball gets to be too much, because it's gonna create some extra core challenge here, you can do this whole series without the ball. So up to you, you can do the series with the ball or without the ball. Hands come behind the head, elbows are wide. We're gonna start by just extending over the ball, getting that nice stretch, and then coming back up to that V-sit position. So while we go through this, you may need to adjust the ball a bit to a position that feels right for you. I have it kind of right between the shoulder blades on the upper back. And we're just kind of extending the neck. Yeah. And if you move that ball back or forward, it's going to create either extra resistance or less resistance. We're going to pause with just a neutral position here. So your back is nice and neutral. Elbows are out wide. We're gonna take the right leg to tabletop. We're gonna take the head back and then crunch back up. Extending back and crunching back up. So kind of finding a little chest lift position here. You're in charge of the range here. If that doesn't feel good to extend over the ball, you can always just stay in a neutral position, but you're also wanting to find that crunch up towards the knee. We're gonna add on. Head comes back. As you come up, you reach that leg forward. As you come back down, the leg comes to tabletop. As you crunch up, you reach the leg to 45. And then as you come down, back to tabletop. So you should be starting to feel the core warm up here. Again, if the ball gets to be too much, you can do this same series on the mat with the head up or down. Looks good, guys. We have a few more like this, really warming up that core, finding that balance on the ball. Let's do one more. We're gonna hold up in that crunch. Leg extends, little pulses up and down with the core. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Foot comes down, extend back over the ball. Take an inhale and an exhale. When you're ready, other side. Left leg comes to tabletop, neutral position. You're coming, starting with just that crunch, leg stays still. The side could feel different than the other side. We're using that opposite oblique. Keep the collarbone open. You can see the elbows right in your peripheral vision, but they're not weight bent, and it's just a gentle hold of the head. We're taking this nice and slow and controlled to find that core work. You can speed it up, but the slower you take it, the more you're gonna feel this here. We're gonna add that extend on. So as you come up, you extend the leg to 45. As you come back, leg comes to tabletop. Feeling the core work here. Kind of a variation of our single leg stretch. Breathing in and breathing out. Try not to push too hard into the right foot or the foot that you have on the mat. We're gonna press out and extend, little crunches up, up, up for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Set it back down, extend over the ball, take an inhale and an exhale. I got one more set here with the ball where it's at. So we're gonna start hands to the mat. You're gonna take the legs one at a time into tabletop. If at any point this gets to be too much, you can take feet flat back down to the mat. We're gonna go into some hundreds here. So you're gonna have to find that balance on the ball. Arms are gonna come up, find your balance here. If that's too much, hands can stay down towards the mat and you can do your hundreds right here. Otherwise, we're starting here, finding our balance. We're gonna reach hands to hips. Inhale back to 90. Exhale, hands to hips. Inhale back to 90. Balance challenge gets to be too much, you can ditch the ball or take the feet flat to the mat. If you want to add on, we're going to be extending the legs here as well on this next one. We start pumping for our hundreds, breathing. 2, 3, 4, 5, out. 2, 3, 4, 5, in. 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm adding that in with the knees in tabletop, the out with the legs at 45 to go through our hundreds here. You're reaching those fingertips nice and long. You're breathing in for 5 and out for 5, balancing on the ball using your core. About halfway done, keep on pumping in. 2, 3, 4, 5, out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 60. 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 70. 2, 3, 4, 5, out. 2, 3, 4, 5, 80. Keep chin to chest. In. 2, 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 90. Last set, breathe in. Last set, breathe out. Set the feet down, remove the ball. Feel that nice relief with the ball gone. You can take the ball into your hands. Catch your breath, let the knees sway side to side. Take an inhale and an exhale as we go into all these different steps. There's lots of options, so you can always step back a step if it gets to be too much. Shake it out, catch your breath here. Core should feel nice and warmed up. All right. Ball is going to go underneath the feet. Again, ball is optional. So I have legs together. I have my arches on top of that ball. And then I have the ball scooched in towards the glutes. And again, if the ball gets to be too much at any point, another good option would be you can have toes down on the mat and your heels just on the ball, depending on the size of the ball here and what feels best. So we're going to go into a little bridging. So hands pressed down into the mat. Without doing anything, we're just going to find a pelvic rock. Inhale, you have that neutral spine. Exhale, tilt the pelvis forward, imprint the spine. Inhale, back to neutral. Exhale, imprint, tilt the pelvis without lifting the hip. So it's just kind of like a little prep, our pelvic tilt or pelvic rock before we go into our bridge. And we're going to add some extra balance challenges on here. Again, ball is going to create a huge balance challenge, so if at any point it is too much, you do this without the ball. Inhale, exhale, slowly press into that ball, lifting the hips a couple inches into your bridge. Inhale, exhale, scoop back down. See how that feels? If you want to ditch the ball at this point, you can. Otherwise, you're squeezing those legs together, lifting the hips, feeling that in the legs, in the calves, in the feet, as well as the glutes as you lift those hips. And again, with the ball, you're probably going to have a smaller range than you would on the mat. The goal is to still warm up that back body and find the glutes. Looks good. So lifting those hips, squeeze the glutes, and coming back down. Challenging here with the ball. Again, press evenly with both arches. On this next one, we're just holding up. Hold up in that bridge, little pulse up and down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Scoop back down, press the ball away, get a nice stretch, legs extend. Yeah, bring it back in. One more, legs extend. And then bring it back. And we're gonna do one last little set here. Same thing, press the feet into the ball, go into your bridge. So pressing into those arches. Inhale, exhale, scoop up into your bridge. Inhale, exhale, scoop back down. Continue like this. I'm just gonna shut the door. I don't know if it'll help or not. Okay, adding on to that bridge, feet are still on the ball, you're going to inhale, exhale, press up into your bridge, hold, butterfly the knees, open and close, keeping the hips up. You could always do this with the hips down. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, scoop all the way down, press that ball away, nice hamstring stretch, bend the knees back in. Press the ball away. And bring the ball back in. All right. You're going to grab the ball into your hands. Now it's going to go underneath the tailbone. So you'll pipe those hips up. Ball's going to go kind of like a little bunny tail right underneath the tailbone. Knees are bent, feet flat on the mat here. You want to kind of tuck the pelvis so that you're imprinting into that ball. And again, the ball may move around and shift, so you'll have to kind of just see what works best for you here. All right, we are gonna start. Two options here. Hands can either go down to the mat to start. When we continue, you can take your hands up to 90. It's gonna be a balance challenge. So start by first just taking those legs to tabletop. Find your balance position here. And then we're going to take the legs all the way up to 90. And again, if you need to adjust where the ball's at to have that position, you can. We're going to go into a really slow scissors. So right leg goes down to 45. And then you switch. Nice and slow. Balancing on the ball. Using that belly button to core, that belly button to spine activation. You want to add on here, you take those arms up to 90. Nice and slow, finding that balance challenge on the ball. If that is too much, hands can come back down to the mat. You're still finding that core work here. Nice and slow, reaching that leg, feeling the stretch on the back of the leg here. Also using that core work to find your balance. We're going nice and slow. Breathing in, breathing out. If you ever need to take hands back to the mat to adjust, you can. Feel that stretch on the back of the legs. You're pointing those toes, reaching nice and long. Slower you go, more control you're going to have. Let's do two more like this. Last one. And then hands come back to the mat, feet come back to the mat. Take an inhale and an exhale. Adjust the ball if you need. We're going to go into our next set here. It's our bicycle. So start with hands at the mat, legs to tabletop. And then taking those legs all the way back up to 90. We're going to do our bicycle legs here. So you'll reach one leg out and then the other, finding those bicycle legs. Feel the stretch in the back of the leg as you do this. It's like you're pedaling in one direction. If this is going well and you want to add on, take it slow. Arms can go up to 90 again. Finding your balance, as you flow through that bicycle. Not required. Slower you go, more control you're gonna have here, and you're gonna feel that in the core. We are gonna reverse those bicycles. You could feel different going the other way. Feel that stretch of the legs, controlling your movement here. Breathing in and out, balance work. Collarbone is nice and open, belly button to spine. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Set it on down, feet down, hands down, shake it out. Take an inhale and an exhale. Adjust the ball if you need. We got one more set here with the ball on the tailbone. Legs come up to tabletop, all the way up to 90. You're gonna find a Pilates V. Heels together, toes apart, so you have a little bit of an external rotation. We're gonna go right back into our scissors, but in this external rotation. So you're gonna reach the leg nice and long, keeping both legs externally rotated, and then you switch. Still keep them close together, like they're just about to brush each other. We're just in that external rotation now. Heels are in, toes are out. It might feel a little bit different. You'll feel it a little bit more on that outer thigh there. If this is going well, nice and slow and controlled, you can take those arms up to 90, finding the balance as you continue with your scissors here in that external rotation. So as one leg lifts, the other leg lowers. Use your core, breathing in and out, nice and slow and controlled. Good job, guys. Keep pushing through, using that core nice and slow and controlled. In that external rotation. Feel that stretch on the back of the leg. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands to the mat, feet down to the mat. Take an inhale and an exhale. You can take that ball out. Feel that nice relief on the back. Let the knees sway side to side, or take a big inhale and exhale here. Alright, so we're going to go into our second set of bridging here. Now the ball is going to go in between the knees. Ball is in between the knees. Feet are nice and neutral. Parallel position on the mat there. Find that neutral spine position, that little pocket of air underneath the low back. Starting just with a simple bridge here. Keep that squeezing on the ball. Inhale. Exhale, slowly scoop up, squeeze those glutes. Inhale, exhale, scoop one bone at a time back down. Continue like this, just finding your bridge here. Press into the big toe, not rolling out to the pinky side part of the foot. And there's no strain in the neck or the face or the shoulders. We are gonna add on, pause down at the bottom, inhale. Exhale, press up into your bridge, hold. Extend the right leg. Right leg comes back down. Scoot, and then extend the left leg. Left leg comes back down, inhale. Exhale, slowly scoop. One bone at a time, back down. Inhale, exhale, scoop up. You're reaching that leg, keeping the squeeze in on the ball. Reaching the other leg, nice and controlled, scooping back down. Continue like this, finding those leg extensions here. Maybe you alternate switching sides, but keep that pressure on the ball. Keep the hips nice and active and glutes are up. Finish the one you're on. We're gonna meet all the way back down at the bottom. All right, we are gonna add on. Inhale, exhale, scoop up and hold. As you extend the right leg, left heel's gonna lift, squeeze the ball. Left heel comes down, right foot comes down. Left leg extends, right heel lifts. Set it back down and scoop back down. A few more like this. You're gonna feel that more on the calves and the ankles if those heel lifts aren't working for you. You can stick with the leg extensions or just the bridging up and down. So the heel will lift as the opposite leg extends. Yep. We have a few more like this. Adding on with our progressions. And then finish the one you're on. Take a big inhale and exhale. We're gonna add on, inhale. Exhale, scoop all the way up and hold. Arms are gonna come up to 90. You can always keep hands back down to the mat. You're gonna extend the right leg, left heel lifts. Little pulses on the ball for 3, 2, 1. Right foot down, left heel. Left leg extends, little pulse for 3, 2, 1, back down, roll it down, hands down, remove the ball, take a nice hamstring stretch. So different progressions there. You can pick and choose, not all of them need to be done at once. Get that nice hamstring stretch. We're gonna do one more set here like that, so ball in between the knees. With our bridge series here, a little pressure in on that ball. We're gonna inhale. Exhale, scoop up into our bridge, hold. Option to take the arms up to 90. Option to lift both heels. Little hip thrust up towards the ceiling. 1 inch up, 1 inch down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Press up and slowly roll down, hands come down. Last one here, inhale. Exhale, scoop up into your bridge and hold. Arms go up to 90. Heels can alternate. One heel lifts, lowers. One heel lifts, lowers as you hold into your bridger. As you do this, squeeze the ball. Hips stay nice and level. We pause with both heels up. Pulses on the ball. Little pulse. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, exhale, slowly lower. Everything back down. Take the legs up. Good job, guys. Point and flex the toes. Roll the ankles in one direction and then the other direction. All right. Ball's going to go in between the ankles and then we're going to press up onto our forearms. So, onto the forearms here. We're going to take the legs to tabletop. Collarbones open, belly button to spine. You're gonna reach the legs to 45, back to table. So we're kind of in a boat position here. Squeezing in on the ball. You should feel the core work here. You can always do this all the way down on the mat or without the ball. The ball is gonna create extra resistance. You can stick here if you wanna add on. Pressing out to 45, hold, pulse on that ball. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, bring it back down, set everything down, take an inhale and exhale. Good job, guys. We're gonna do one more like that. Ball goes in between the ankles. You can keep head down or you can come back to that forearm position, that boat position. Legs are in tabletop. Again, either way, head can stay down if it's too much here. We're gonna press out. As we press out, right arm is gonna reach. Bringing it back to table, hand comes down. As we press out, left arm reaches. Set it back down. Again, arm reaches are optional. You can stick with just that boat, that tabletop to 45, but you're gonna feel that opposite oblique as you reach. You're just reaching right in front. Looks good. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, set it down. We're gonna forward fold. Take an inhale and an exhale. Good job, guys. A lot of core work there. Breathing in, breathing out. All right. We're in like a V-sit position here, stacked up tall. We're gonna roll a little bit back. You have open knees here. So knees bent, open knees, ball's gonna come into the hands. We're gonna start with just a march here, and you're in charge. Stacked up tall is gonna be the easiest way. If you want more of a challenge, you're a little bit more back into that V-sit. We're gonna start by just marching legs and tabletop. Yeah, you're gonna feel this in the hip, but keep the ribcage nice and closed, drawing the ribcage towards the hips here. You can stay here if you wanna add on. We're gonna pass that ball as the knees lift. Again, more challenging this is to go lower. Or you can just stick with passing that ball up in that stacked up position. Breathing in, breathing out. Try to keep yourself in the same place with the core there. So if you're in that back position, you're holding there, you're not going forward and backward. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Forward fold, take an inhale and an exhale. All right, we're gonna come to a 4-point kneeling position. We're gonna use the ball here in a second, but you could just put it between the knees as we go into a cat-cow stretch. So just nice stretch here. We did a lot of flexion with the core. Inhale, press your low back up towards the ceiling. Exhale, creating that arch, getting that nice stretch here. Breathing in and breathing out. Perfect. All right, pausing back in a neutral spine. I'm gonna put ball underneath right hand. Again, ball's optional. It's gonna create a balance challenge. You can always tuck it to the side if it's too much, because you can still get the work without the ball. All right, ball is underneath the right hand. Left leg is gonna extend to the mat. You're gonna lift that left leg and lower it. As you lift, press into the ball. Lower, release. Lift, press into the ball. Lower, release. Try to keep everything nice and squared off. You've got the balance challenge there of the ball. We're just pressing the ball and lifting the leg. Find that left glute as you squeeze up. Don't let the back arch. So you're finding the glute, not letting the back arch. We have two more like this. Last one, hold up for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, press on back into a child's pose position. We're gonna add on. You can always just stick with that option we just did there. All right, back to 4-point kneeling. You're gonna take that leg out, and then it's gonna lift up and hold. If you're adding on, as you press you're gonna press the ball away, bringing the knee in, almost like a fire hydrant, and then pressing the leg out, ball rolls back in. Ball rolls out, bend the knee towards your left shoulder, and then press back out. You're gonna feel that glute there. Yep, again, the ball is just an extra add-on. You can do this just holding the ball in place as well. Feel that glute work. We have a few more like this. Let's do one last one. Reach that leg long, press on back into a child's pose position. All right. Back to 4-point kneeling, ball is still underneath that right hand. Options here, we're gonna thread the needle. So you're gonna grab that ball. You can keep in the 4-point kneeling, or you can extend that left leg back. You're gonna reach the ball up towards the ceiling, thread the needle underneath. Reach the ball up, thread the needle underneath. You could stay in that 4-point kneeling. You can stay where we're at here. If you want to add on, try it with the leg lifted. Left leg is lifted. Maybe just an inch off the mat. Thread the needle. Much more challenging for that balance here. Again, maybe you just try a couple. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Set it back down. Press on back, child's pose. All right, we're gonna go to the other side. So starting with that ball underneath the left hand, We're just starting taking that right leg out. As you lift the right leg, you press into the ball. Right toe taps down, right leg lifts, press into the ball. Breathing in, breathing out. And on this next one, you just hold that leg up, press the ball down for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, press on back, child's pose. All right, back to that 4-point kneeling, ball is underneath the left hand. Again, we're gonna slide that ball out. Starting with the right leg back behind, you're gonna lift up, slide it out, you're pressing into that fire hydrant, and returning to start. Fire hydrant, return to start. Balance challenge here, you can keep the ball still, it's up to you. You're bending that right knee in towards the right elbow to get that fire hydrant. It's a balance challenge here. Looks good, guys, keep belly button to spine. Working the glute, cinching in through the waistline. Let's do two more. Last one. And press on back, child's pose. You guys know it's coming. We only got one more on this side. We're gonna thread that needle. So again, you can stay in that 4-point kneeling or you can press that right leg out. Ball's gonna go up towards the ceiling, you thread the needle. If you wanna add on, you keep that right leg lifted as you do your thread the needle here. Not required. Nice and slow, feel that stretch of the shoulder. Using your core, balance work here. We're here for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, set it down, press on back, child's pose. All right, we're gonna go to a side position here. So I'm gonna have ball underneath the side. If that doesn't work for you, you can do it without the ball. And I'm gonna be prepped up on the elbow. If you're not using the ball, you can be all the way down, propped up on the forearm, whatever feels best for you. I'm gonna be elbow. So the reason I have this ball here is because I wanna feel like you're lifting up off the ball. Normally when we're on our sideline, we can lay all the way down. You kinda wanna feel like you're lifting up off the ball. I'm gonna take top hand to the head, but you could keep it here, here for your balance, whatever feels best for you. We're gonna start with just a lift and a lower. Bottom knee can be bent if that feels better for you, or you can have both legs extended. Looks good. Try to keep everything parallel. Feel like you're lifting up off that ball. You have options here. If that's too much a balance challenge, you can keep your hand here. If the ball is too much, you can take the ball out and just lay all the way down. Good, you're finding that contraction here of the glute, keeping everything nice and parallel, controlling the movement. Pull belly button to spine, not letting the top of the rib cage flared open. We're gonna add on, it's gonna be a lift. Forward, back, set down. Lift, forward, back, set down. Nice and controlled. Side work here, feel like you're lifting up off of that ball. Good job, guys. We have a few more like this. Last one here, make it your best, nice and controlled. And then remove the ball. We'll go over to the other side. So, not a huge long set here. Ball underneath that side body. I'm on elbow here, starting with just that lift in the lower. Feel like you're lifting up off the ball, belly button to spine. drawing the ribcage towards the hip. The hold here of the head, we're not pressing the head forward or backward. It's just a nice neutral position. You're feeling that contraction here of the glute, that side body there. Looks good. Nice and controlled. Keep the hips stacked, so don't let the top hip roll backward or roll forward. That ball is just under there so that you feel like you're lifting up off of it. We add on, come forward, back, set it back down, lift, forward, back, set it back down. Breathing in and out, use your core to keep your balance on that ball, lifting up off the ball. Hand can always go to the hip or the mat. It doesn't need to be a huge range here. You do what you can control, keeping belly button spine. Looks good, let's do two more. Last one. And remove that ball. We're gonna lay it on our back and you can get a nice little figure four stretch for both legs. So ball just comes into the hands. Take one leg, cross it over the other leg. Take a big inhale and exhale and then we switch, making sure to get the other side too. All right, coming back up to a seated position. We're gonna come to kneeling. We're gonna extend one leg out. So again, if that's too much, you can keep just in the kneeling position. If that's too much on your knees, you can come seated and I can give you a modification. Otherwise, I have right leg out. Right hand is gonna come to behind the head. Ball is gonna come to the left hip here. Again, ball's optional, up to you. We're gonna press down, finding a side bend as you roll that ball down, and then come back up to neutral. So, I mean, ball's not doing much, it's just rolling down as you find that side bend. You can tuck the back toe if that feels better to help you with your balance. But it's like you're in between two panes of glass and you're finding that side work. You're not crunching forward, you're not crunching back. Looks good. We're going to do one more like this. All the way up, take the ball into your hands. Ball is going to come up. Right leg is still extended here. Same thing, a little bit harder. Side bend here and back up if this is too much. Go back to what we just did. Keep belly button to spine. Using the oblique and core. Let's do two more like this. Last one, return to start, shake it out. Gonna add on, you could always just stick with what we were just doing there. Ball comes up. We're gonna go up to a diagonal. You're gonna bend in towards the ankle, press back out on the diagonal, come back up to top. You go side bend, bend the knee as you come in, back to that diagonal, and back up. Just adding a little rotation here. Do what works for you. Kind of a wood chopper movement. Let's do one more. And then we'll return to start. You can come to four-point kneeling and shake it out before we go to the other side. Roll out the shoulders if that feels good. It's a tough one today. You guys are doing good. Back to that kneeling position. We'll go other side. All right. Ball to the right hip, hand behind the left hand behind the head. Again, this is our first option here. You can always stick with this. Glass. the ribcage close. Pull the ribcage towards the hips. Belly button is fine here. If you have shoulder issues, you could always just keep the ball here. Let's do two more. Last one. Return to start. Shake it out. Last set here. You guys got it. When you're ready, up to 90. Diagonal. You're going to bend in towards the ankle. Press back out. And 90. Diagonal to the ankle. Press back out to 90. A few more like this. Again, if it's too much of a balance challenge, you go back to one of those other options. Almost done here, guys. This is our last big set, and then I'm going to give us some stretches. Push through. Keep the belly button to spine. Don't let the back arch. Let's do one more. Back up to 90. Bring the ball down. Big inhale and exhale. Shake it out. All right, let's get some stretches here. Ball can go to the side. We worked a lot of the side body, so let's do that mermaid stretch. So, legs straight out in front. Crisscross or Z sit. You decide what feels better for you. If you're in the Z-sit, one hand to the ankle, other arm out to a T. Otherwise, you just decide which way you're going towards that ankle. Nice side stretch. Inhale back to center. Exhale, reach up and over. Back to center. We'll do one more this way. And then find that counter stretch the other direction. Switch legs if you're in the Z-sit. Otherwise, you'll just go to the opposite direction. When you're ready, try to keep the hips down, finding that nice side stretch here. Looks good. One more like this, and then find that little counter stretch. Crisscross or legs straight out in front, either way. Arms come out to a T, palms facing down. We'll go into our spine and twist the inner pulse. Pulse one direction, center. Getting some nice rotation here. Gaze goes with that back hand. Twist from the core more than the shoulders here. Let's do one more each side. Back to center, nice big shoulder roll. We go to four-point kneeling. We're going to come up to standing here. So tuck the toes, pike the hips up to down dog. You can pedal the legs out if that feels good, bending one knee then the other knee. Nice stretch on the back of the calves. Walking the feet in towards the hands. Shift the weight to the feet. Inhale, exhale, slowly roll it up. One bone at a time. We'll finish with some roll downs here. Inhale, arms up. Exhale, reach up and over. Let your head hang heavy. Shake your head no. Shake your head yes. Inhale, exhale, slowly roll up. One bone at a time. Inhale, up. Exhale, up and over one side, and over to the other side. Inhale, exhale, hands away. Inhale, up. A little back bend if it feels okay. Gaze goes up. Inhale, exhale, hands away. Last one here. Inhale, up. And start center. And you guys are all done. Thank you guys so much. That was a tough one today, so... You guys did great. If you have any questions,